spirit shall lead me unto the land of uprightness. For you said your name, O Lord, you shall quicken me. In your righteousness you shall bring my soul out of trouble. In your mercy you shall utterly destroy my enemy. And you shall destroy all those who affect my soul. I am your servant.
God is the Lord who has revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Worthy of divine guidance and your care, for you alone are God.
support of the faithful, the only all praise one.
Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit,
dissipate the cloud of my sinfulness, so bright above with the brightness of your advent. For you brought forth the light, the divine which was before all time.
Thank you.
pia crucem et mai evangelium, irini pasim. Et luca talutana evangelium con agnos va, pros comem. Those days Mary rose and went apace into the hill country to a city of Judah, and she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. And when Elizabeth heard the greeting of Mary, the babe leaped in her womb. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit, and she exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why is this granted me that the mother of my Lord should come to me? Behold, when the voice of your greeting came to my ears, the babe in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her from the Lord." And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has regarded the low estate of his handmaid. For behold, henceforth all generations will call me blessed, for he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name." And Mary remained with her about 3 months, and returned to her
Yeah. Y no los de los ojos se vea y no ve.
Lord, have mercy. be kind to and treat as our good God, who loves all people, that he may turn away and scatter all wrath and disease that was against us. Deliver us from his impending justified chastisement and have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Then we pray, Lord God, we hear the voices of the petitions of us sinners and have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Hear us, O God, our Savior, the hope of all the ends of the earth, for those far off upon the sea. Show compassion on us, O Master, on the many sins, and have mercy upon us. For merciful and loving God, are you, to you we give glory, to the Father, to the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to our God, glory to you.
In the middle of these consonants, those are the vowels. parts and separations, and if you don't translate them the right way, you don't even know what it's saying. But thankfully, to the 70 that translated this into the Hebrew scripture into Greek, that book was able to be read. That's what God wanted. God wanted the book to be able to be read, not just by the Hebrews, but by everyone. He didn't want it to be held back. It's one of the things that that some people say, oh, I'm a Bible study. You have to hold it back. No, you don't hold it back. Bible can be read by anyone. Scriptures are for everyone, but not to be understood privately. Read them, but don't try to interpret them on your own. And this is one of the passages that helps us understand that you're not supposed to understand Scripture on your own. And Philip was called to this chariot when the Ethiopian was reading the Scripture. He was finally able to read the Hebrew Scripture, but in Greek, and he was reading it, and Philip says, do you understand? He's like, I have no clue. Somebody's got to guide me. And what Philip and what the eunuch was reading at that moment was actually part of our Bible study that we're doing now. So we haven't gotten there yet. It was from the book of Isaiah. And it talked about how Jesus was going to come and how he was going to die for our sins and how he was going to be stricken and be a person that was, bearing our diseases and all of these things. And Philip's like, I knew that. And the scripture at that point, Acts of the Apostles says something really powerful. It says he opened his mouth and talked to him about the gospel. That seems like it's a redundant thing to say. You can't talk to somebody about the gospel without opening your mouth. It's the truth. You can preach the gospel without opening your mouth, but you can't talk to him about the gospel without opening your mouth. Even some of the saints of the church were the best. They didn't speak a word. They could preach the gospel just by their actions. But here it says, Philip opened his mouth and talked to him about the gospel. Spoke to him about the gospel, about the good news. Which is a redundancy of terms. And it's important that we understand. When we open our mouths, not always good things come out of them, myself included. When we open our mouths, not always good things come out. When Philip opened his mouth, he opened his mouth in a way that allowed for God to speak through him. Philip had no clue where he was going. He didn't even know what it was for. There was no way he could have prepared himself. Okay, I'm going to see this Ethiopian eunuch. He's going to be reading the Bible. I'm going to be talking to him about this section of the Bible. I'm going to prepare myself. Right? He had no clue. No. God put him, boom, opened his mouth and preached and spoke and said words that were not from him. He spoke Christ. That Philip could speak Christ. Was he a learned man? No, he wasn't necessarily a learned man. He may have had a little bit of book learning. That's fine. But that's not the reason why he was able to speak Christ. The reason he was able to speak Christ was because he was filled with Christ. I open my mouth, and NFL comes out. Steelers come out. Yankees lost to the Red Sox last night. That comes out. That's what happens when I open my mouth. It's the truth. It's not because it's more important than Christ. It's because that's what I filled myself with last night. That's what I filled myself with. So I open my mouth. This is what comes out. But you see, when we fill ourselves with Christ, comes out of our souls. It's what comes out of our hands. It's what comes out of our feet. It's what comes out of our mind. It's what comes out of our hearts. There's no room for anything else. And we know that that's exactly the case of Philip, because why? Because the angel said, get up and go, and he went. Grab my phone, check my schedule to see if it's open. Say, I'm like, maybe I can work in here, maybe I can work in here. And I'm like, you know, can I help? But it's the truth. I gotta work it all in. And I struggle sometimes with that. I struggle with sometimes recognizing the moment. This is the moment. This is the time. There's no other time. Philip knew. Get up, go. He understood and recognized. And because he had filled himself with Christ, when he opened his mouth, our Lord came out. We have to fill our lives with the Lord of Christ. We have to fill our hearts with Him. We have to fill our time more with Him. Even in the midst of everything else that we're doing. Because those things are important. Making a living, doing the things, taking care of our families, those are all important. But in that, so that when it's time to have Christ be with our family, He's there. So when it's time to have Christ be a part of our work, He's there. So when it's time to have Christ a part of our caretaking or whatever it is that we're doing, He's there. He's already there. Why? Because we're in wrong when we realize it or not. Because we made an effort to do that before we got there, and made an effort to do it while we were doing it. Today, we want to bring it forward. Do I know what the next event of my life is going to bring? I have no clue. No clue. But I know that I'm going to try to fill it with prayer. How much I love. So that the space and the time and the atmosphere can be filled with my Savior. This is what we have to do. Fill our lives with so that Christ comes out of our lives. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, have a blessing. I still have some of that blood from the Vito icon, so come forward as you venerate the icon. I mean, come forward to receive that blessing. All those do you shelter, O good one, those who
Lord.
the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, that God have mercy on us and save our hearts.
Amen.
May the Holy Trinity bless, protect, and keep all of you. May the blessing of the EAB be with you now and forever. We will have church next week at 6 o'clock, but it will not be Baraka season. We are going to be having the Divine Liturgy of St. Luke the following day on Thursday morning, so we will have great vespers for St. Luke the Evangelist. That day is a personal day, not only for the Feast of St. Luke, who adores our wall, our conventive up there, but also a personal day because on that day, 29 years ago, 29 years ago, Father George Christolini's Stella, George Stella, the age of his nephew, fell asleep in the Lord. And so it's a personal day for me. It's a very a day of reflection. It's a day that I promised myself that as long as I was able to, I would have liturgy. Not only for the honor of the glorious apostle evangelist Luke, but also on behalf of one of the beautiful people in my life that always filled his life with Christ. So that's a beautiful thing that I that will be for the rest of my days as long as I can. So we will have obviously church this coming Sunday, no services that I think in between, but we'll have as we tail out starting Wednesday and then Thursday and then Saturday, and, you know, we'll have a few services coming. So, God bless you, and have a wonderful, blessed rest of your evening. Be well with your